Hello again and welcome to drafting Kaladesh Remastered. So this set has arrived at Magic the Gathering Arena, and this is actually available as traditional draft for 1 week only, but still that is a lot better than nothing because I do prefer the best of three matches here. So you can test the timestamp for the actual draft start in the description below, but I have to say one thing or a couple of things here now. First of all, I haven't drafted this format, of course, in quite some time. I do remember some of the cards from the format, and I have checked the spoiler as well, that what specifically is or is not in the Kaladesh Remastered set, because of course it doesn't cover the entire card pool from Kaladesh and Aether Revolt. So what I'm saying is that I do not know exactly what kind of cards to play around. I don't have any idea about combat tricks in this format. So this is my first draft of this set, and I'm going to record it. So be prepared that I might make some mistakes that I wouldn't be making in, let's say, after 10 to 15 drafts. But the other thing I wanted to mention about is that I am also collecting this set, which means that if I see a mythic rare, I'm most likely going to pick it. I won't be rare drafting regular rares because they're quite easy to acquire when you draft a lot and you get most of the packs. And of course, I have quite a few of these wild cards too. So I'm not gonna rare draft regular rares. I'm only picking regular rares if they go into my deck, but I will most likely pick any mythic rare that I see because they are the most difficult to come by. That said, let's now hop into the draft. So again, I won't be able to see on the first glance what is good and what is bad in the pack, but I'm definitely taking the combustible Gear Hulk in here because, well, it's a mythic rare. And like I said in the introduction, that I will pick most mythic rares because I want to increase my collection. But also this is a very nice card. 6/6 first striker for 6 mana with a pretty decent Enderset battlefield ability. Not the best of the Gear Hulks, but definitely a card worth picking. And other cards, I'll just quickly try to see what other cards we have here. Okay, this is fine. Okay, draws a card at least, but it's a very tough crew cost. Okay, this is good if you got a lot of artifacts. That's fine. Okay, I don't think this is a particularly strong pack, but of course I'm just happy I got a good card from there. And then it seems like the rare has been picked, so it seems like I'm going to probably take the unlicensed disintegration. It says destroy target creature, and it's an instant that costs only 3 mana, so it's definitely an amazing card, even if it doesn't deal any damage. So I'll just reserve that pick, and of course I'm not gonna follow it up, the red card with the white-black card, although it is a nice one. Okay, this is good when you have some kind of artifact generics more. How about the commons in here? Yeah, there's no reason to pick a red card Chandra's Pyrohelix here because this is so much better. I'd rather try to draft a red-black in here. Okay, Essence Extraction is very good. Hidden Stockpile is definitely a good card as well. But again, it's a white-black, and I'm trying to at least see if black-red could be open, and definitely this is a third decent black-red card I'm picking here, so it seems good so far. This thing is quite good too when you have a bunch of artifact creatures. And then we have some other color cards. Yeah, they are. I think this green card is quite fine. Not the best, but it's fine for a common 4/4 Trampler, or you can decide it to come with as a 3/3 and then with a token as a friend. But anyway, this removal is the pick in here, and let's see if black and red shall remain open. So Okay, a trick. Yeah, not interested. Okay, so they don't have any artifacts yet, so I don't think I'm gonna take the Fenhauler. I'm not sure if this is a good card that I should pick now and then force artifacts. I don't think so. I think it's gonna be live fast, because while I don't have any energy synergies right yet, right now, but I have already two removals, so card draw is going to be interesting. I think I'll pick it. Okay, we got another one of these things. What's this say? 1/1. Sideboard card, yes. But I don't think I'm interested in picking that. Okay. Alright, so there's no black or red card in here, and there's not an artifact card I'm interested in picking either, because these basically are blue cards. Is there anything to... I mean, I could take another one of these. I guess I take, but I don't really see myself playing. I mean, two might be too much. At least I'm not gonna play anymore, but... I just want to see if I can stick to the black-red archetype, because... Okay, it seems like it's being cut somehow, but in this format there are a lot of artifacts, and the quality of these cards is so good that I'm maybe willing to kind of just sacrifice a bit in the quality of my later picks, and I maybe pick some artifacts to offset that. I mean, this is a fine card, I think, 2/1 first tracker, but still... Artificer, +1/+2... Mobile card. I don't know. I mean, maybe I'll take this. I'm just not sure if it's that very good. I mean, the Kruitsu might just be a little too much for 3 mana 3/4, but let's see. There's a self-assembler. I'm going to be interested in that. That's just... okay, this is good. Okay, this is good removal, but this actually is quite nice if you can get more of these. I mean, if I'm going to pick these, I think I should start now. I like the Die Young, especially because I have two of these live fasts, but I want to try if I can get these. If I had some kind of controlist deck which has a lot of removal, hopefully, and then I can have this kind of card advantage, 4/4s, that's just win the game. Maybe. Okay, that's not interesting. This is good, definitely, if I'm not going to play either of these colors. I think I'm going to take the blue card. I think it's clearly the best card if I end up with a lot of artifacts. It of course means that I would have to abandon either red or black in here, but maybe it is worth it. Anyway, here's a 5/5/4, not interested. I'm only interested in these self-assemblers or some very good bumps as 5 drops. Improvise and Menace. Okay, this is actually interesting. This could be a 3/3 Menace in some cases. I think I'll play this and let's see if I can pick a couple of more artifacts. I mean, I guess now this is maybe interesting, but paying 5 mana to draw the card is just pretty awful. I'll take the Pyro Helix. This is actually a fine card. I guess I'm not interested in the Defender here, but this is an artifact card. Has Menace if you invest a little bit of mana. 3 mana 3/2, of course, not great stats, but if I have artifact synergies in the deck, I want to pick those, any artifact in that case. This really needs blue blue to do anything, so maybe I'll just take the 3/2, which is not interesting maybe, but let's pick it anyway. This is for sideboard, and this is for sideboard. Okay, so another mythic rare, which I'm picking, and this is actually quite good. Crew 3 is of course a lot, but I mean, this also has an ETB ability. Yeah, I mean, this is pretty good. I also have I have actually now interest in any three power creature. For example, this infiltrator has three power, this has three power. So yeah, I will be picking this, but I'll just quickly try to see if there is something interesting in here. I mean, I really don't. I need to read this card because I have no idea what these do based on the picture alone. But yeah, it is pretty easy pick here. Bomad Courier, is that good in Limited? It's definitely not as good in Limited as it is in Constructed. Flying Lifelink. Okay. I mean, 2-2 Flying Lifelink for 4, it doesn't seem that bad necessarily. Nah, that's fine. Okay, this seems actually fine too. I might be interested in this cheaper card now. This works, this can generate a 1-1 and artifact, which might be. I don't think the Bomad Courier is necessarily such a good card in Limited. I might be just completely wrong there, but it feels like I want this kind of 1-1 Death Toucher, which I can put my energies to some use. Okay, so this is a familiar card because this also is the same card in the Zendikar Rising set. Then there is Chandra's Revolution. Okay, this is good. 4 mana sorcery speed, deal 4. And also it could be jamming their land too, but what's this? This is gonna be good too. Okay, this is also good. Man, okay, this actually might be the better card in here. I mean, this pings a creature, right? And it does it twice without any help. And I already have here energy producing cards. I think this is better than the 4 mana removal. Could be wrong too, but let's try this uncommon. I think those commons will be seen more commonly. Alright, so I think I'll take the self-assembler in here. This is fine. Just two opponents, okay, no, definitely not that great. This is, I just take them. This is great card, but of course I'm not blue-white. So, self-assembler, let's put this to sideboard. Okay, I'm still interested in cheap cards. Don't have that many of them. 4 mana, 2-2 or 3-3 flyer. Not interested. That's not a cheap card. Okay, this chaser is good. I know there's another self-assembler, but this is actually a very decent 2-drop. Gonna pick that. Yeah. I have now some energy team in this deck as well. So, screw 5. Okay, that's not a good one. Okay, so this pings for 1 and then... I don't know. I have one improvised card, I think. I don't really know how much of a artifact synergy I have here after all. I might be taking another one of these three power creatures here because it helps crew this console flagship. Not sure if I'm playing the mobile garrison. I don't think I'm going to play it. Okay, so this is the Hive, I think, from Alpha. Just a bit cheaper to cast and use. And Salivating Gremlings. Okay, I have some artifacts. I've got another one of these. I'm just actually more interested in these three power creatures as a 3-drop. I mean, this can be nice, but I just want to be able to crew this whenever I happen to draw it. And I'm taking another Poisoner in here. And here we don't have much. This is just not gonna be good ever. Let's take this, but I don't think it's really that great of a card. Attacks each combat if able. I'm not really looking to play that kind of... Target creature. Wait a minute. Did I just... missed this on the earlier when I saw this. Okay, that seems pretty good. What's going on? Let's take this, although I'm not gonna play it. I have to make the picks in here. Yeah, I take the 1-3 and maybe the sideboard. Well, I did get the self-assembler here. So, how did I miss this? So, this is instant 3 mana. It deals 3 damage at least to a creature. So, I have no idea what I picked over this card. But this is definitely a good card. Okay, definitely a good card. Okay, and this is great. I got rares from... I picked rares from each pack. I mean, this is just great. Crew 1. Lifelink. Yeah, I mean, this has... Yeah, this is definitely the pick. I don't need to even see what else is in here. I think I would take this as the next choice. But yeah, definitely taking the Harvester in here. I got really good rares in this pack. I mean, this draft in all the 3 packs. Okay, another Cloud Blazer for someone. Okay. 2-mana, 2-1 flyer. Well, that's a nice one, too. It's gonna be the Pyro Helix, or what's this? Oh, this is only activated as a sorcery. It doesn't seem that great. Enters the battlefield. Okay, I mean... I think this is the better sideboard card if the opponent has 1 toughness creatures. Yeah, it is. Maybe I put it to main deck for now, but let's see. Okay. This is another crew 3 card, but it is a 5-5 and it does draw a card when you cast it. So it's gonna be either this, I think, or, well, not this because this requires white. Morphist Squad, I think it's fine, but... I actually don't have 4 drops, but these both are 4 drops. Fabricate, either 4 too many's or 3 1 many's, which comes with an artifact. I think it's both modes are good, but maybe I'll try this uncommon now. It draws a card, and I've picked these 3 power creatures for because of this Sky Sovereign, so... Yeah. They work with this one too. Now I just actually want cheap card because I have 3 of these self-assemblers, for example, so anything cheap and I will pick it. Well, I will take the unlicensed disintegration anyway, yeah, because that is just such a good card. Yeah, definitely better than the options. What's this? Okay, this is good for an aggressive deck, which my deck is not. There's another one of these improvise things. Well, I'm not gonna play the defender and this threaten isn't interesting either. I'm not gonna play Ornithopter. I think I take this for now. Okay. Anything cheap? Okay, Die Young. I'm gonna take it. Yeah, so this is good. So this is a -2/-2. If nothing else. Yeah. And, well, another of these Weltfast monitors. Not a target. Okay, that's fine, but it's a 3-mana 1/2, so I'm not sure if I'm that interested in it. Yeah, let's just take one of these 3 drops. And, well, let's take the sideboard card in here. Don't really... Well, what's this? Lifelink. Okay, it's not so interesting because it doesn't have 3 power. I think I want my creatures to have 3 power, and I have already a lot of 3 drops. Let's take this artifact removal here. And, well... As long as you control an artifact... Do I want to have, like, this? I do have quite a few artifacts in here. Let's take the flyer rather than another one of these infiltrators. I have 2 of those already. And now I can have this for my sideboard, I think. And, well, I did get this menace thing. I think I might try it. It also makes an artifact for my other cards that care about them. And here I think the hijack is more likely to be sideboarded in than the rebel. Sure. Let's take the Ornithopter. Got one of these 2, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna play it. I have so many 3 drops in here. So... So these are the let's just so artifacts, black and red cards. So these are the cards that currently are not in my deck. I don't think I'm gonna main deck any of these. I mean, the Salivating Gremlins might be, but this is more like of an aggressive card, whereas my deck is definitely trying to play removal and then win with the, well, the bombs, and I think the self-assemblers, although I have a lot of fives here, so I need to, and I have the six drop two, so I need to, well, I think that, well, I might need to be, well, I don't know if this is a fast format. I think this format has fast decks, so this deck could just be quite bad, but I guess I have at least a few of these cheap cards, like this 2-mana 1-3 that I can sideboard into. And I have this, so maybe I can sideboard into a deck that has more cheap cards than I currently do, because I didn't end up with that many 2-drops. So I would kind of like to play maybe 18 lands in this deck, because I have, well, this is not going to be played. 5 mana 3/3 is, I don't have room for that. I have already 4 5-drops and 1 6-drop. So I think I'm going to cut at least one of these brawlers, because the improvise isn't going to happen that often. I have some way to, okay, I do have some way to make artifact creatures, 2 of these guys, and 1 of these guys, and 3 of these. But still, this is a lot of cards. I'm gonna definitely cut the mobile garrison. This is not a useful one, but I still need to cut at least 6 and maybe even 7 cards if I really want to play 18 lands. Although I do have 2 card draw spells, if I'm going to play them both, I think then 17 lands is enough, because I get a few extra draws. But I still need to make a lot of cuts in here, and I think the first things I'm going to cut is the both of these infiltrators in here. I don't care about dealing damage to the opponent, and I'd rather play this artifact, the 3/2s. Although, how many of my cards actually care about? Well, I mean, these, actually the Welding Sparks care about me having artifacts. So yeah, this is decent. About this creature, I think I have just so many 3-drops, and I have to cut these trees, and there are so many good 3-drops that I would rather just there are so many cards I want to keep. So okay, this creature is one of my cards in there, and then do I care about, I mean, maybe I will just drop one of these brawlers. Yeah, I think it has to be cut, but I still have a lot of cards. I mean, if I'm playing the self-assemblers, I definitely want to be playing all 3 of them. But do I want to play? Because I do have here some kind of late game in here, because another option is to just cut all of these self-assemblers. I would be at 22 cards, and then maybe add the brawler back in. Otherwise, I'm making two additional cuts in here, so they would have to be like, I think it would have to be the Pyrohelix, and maybe one of these Leave Fasts. Okay, I have to think about this. I'll make a cut in the video, and when I've decided, I will explain my decision tree. Yeah, okay, so I'm going to cut one of these Pyrohelixes, and I'm going to cut actually one of these draw twos, because I just have so many 3-drops, and actually I have even a third vehicle in here, so So I have three things that require creatures on the battlefield for them to do anything. Well, I guess this does something when it enters the battlefield, but still. I want to try it like this. And it's possible that I should lose once more of these expensive cards. But I will sideboard into something cheaper Panaco, because this average cost of 3.4 is quite a lot, and I'm going to play only 17 lands because I really don't want to make any more cards in here. The cards are, because I do need these creatures too. The worst cards in the deck are the creatures, and I guess the Bazaar Barge could be cut too, because it's the worst vehicle I have, but at least I don't have that many 4 drops in here. It's a nice play on turn 4. If you have this kind of 3 power total on the battlefield, you can use it to block on that same turn, and then you can attack if you want to, and it draws a card too. So I'll do it like this, and I'll just add some lands. These require red to activate, but then again I have double black. Don't really know. Which one shall I have? Maybe I will have, because of this essence extraction, I will have 9 swamps. I don't have any other red double casters than the 6 drop. Okay, so let's see. Well, this is a fine hand, but not that great, but of course not going to mulligan this because I have 2 of these 2 drops. But of course I don't want to draw any more than 1 self-assembler, so getting 2 of those is not ideal. Well, that's not... that is not great. They can get rid of... Well, at least I drew a 3 drop, but they could have gotten rid of both of mine. Poisonous. At least I have some other use for the energy that I'm getting from them. Okay, so I need to... So this doesn't really... It's a 2-1-2 flyer. Get some energy and can make other things. This doesn't make a token or doesn't make anyone to make, it doesn't give counters, nor doesn't it make tokens. I think I'm going to, rather than have the Welding Sparks in here up, I will play this Poisoner now, and if they are gonna use 3 mana on their next turn for it, so be it. I'm going to draw a card from this Bazaar Barge anyway, which means that I will kind of recoup the lost card advantage there. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, well now it happened that I have drawn only 3 lands and mostly expensive cards. At least I have the Welding Sparks in here. It will deal 4 currently. Okay, so they made it a 3-2 flyer that is going to be killed by my removal here, and then I hope to draw the land. And yeah, I'm gonna still attack. I don't need this vehicle as a blocker at all. And there's the 5th land too, so now it seems everything is good. Just let's not draw the final self-assembler as my next draw. Okay, that got killed. it's fine because I have here enough place to make with these four fours. Oh, that's sad. Oh boy. Well, at least I got some other playable card here because they were able to jam one of my lands with this removal. So this is quite good, 5-mana 3/3 flyer. All creatures get +1/+1 and vigilance until end of turn. So what does this thing do? Okay, so this deals damage to them if they don't let me draw three cards. Pretty nice. I'm going to offer the trade with the flyer. They're definitely not going to block, I'm sure. So let's get one of my four fours. Get the final one out of the deck so that I don't have to draw it. Okay. Still, they are dealing only 4 per turn. This is fine. So, I think I can play 4. Well, I mean, I think I played it. Yeah, I used the 5 mana here. I don't think it matters that much to play this many guy. So now that they were able to remove my two things, they might be able to win via air. Of course, I do have a lot of removal in this deck, so if I can get rid of that 3/3, that should be pretty easy for me to win then. So they kind of wasted one energy for no reason there. Okay, so let's see what they have next. I'm still not dying to their next attack. So they need to say, okay, so basically they're gonna let me draw 3 in here. But they need to have 2 blockers or removal and a blocker in there. Okay, the harvester is very good because, well, no, this is actually, this can't crew vehicles. This is smart pacifism to make in this kind of format. Okay, so are they going to finish me with... They need one more additional damage and that's it. Alright then. Yes, well that was... that was unfortunate. They were able to... Kill my guys and they had the flyers. And where were my removal? I had one removal in here, I think. Didn't have any others. Well... Okay, so yeah, this is a good pacifism variant for this format. It would be quite bad as a pacifism because vehicles are so common in here. Alright, so... Is the Chandra's Pyro Helix good? I didn't really see that many creatures from there. I did see only 3 creatures there, in fact. 1-2, 3-3 and 3-2 or 2-1, depending on how they choose to deal with the Fabricate. So, they had artifact removal here. Yeah, so am I gonna make some kind of changes in here? Poisoner isn't necessarily that great against that. But it's my only... It's one of my few 2-drops. I still might change one of these poisoners into a... where is it? Pyro Helix. And... okay, this is a 1 toughness creature too. Maybe I'm not gonna sideboard all my 1 toughness creatures away, so... Maybe it's fine like this. I think I still like the self-assembler plan. I just didn't draw my removal in there, so that's why they were able to deal so much damage with the flyers, because I had only one removal for them. Okay, I need one land for the card draw, but I do have a removal for that 2-drop potentially. But if I can't draw the third land, it's going to be quite nasty. Yeah, I don't want to kill 1-2. I really don't want to. Okay, so this was good. So no creature so far. I'm just gonna play the Malfist squad. I think I'm gonna leave the play this as a 3-1. I mean, they can have Chandra's Pyrohelix, but they can deal with it anyway, or they can have the artifact. But then they can have also impeccable timing. I think I will let myself have the 1-1 instead. Yeah, sure. Okay, that is food for my Pyrohelix, no matter which mode they are going to choose. Of course, if I draw the land, I can just kill it with the... Because this, when it enters or attacks. Alright, pretty easy now. Okay, so I did draw the land, which is amazing here, because now I can play the self-assembler and crew the flagship, and yeah. And Fragmentize, which I saw them from them game 1, doesn't work on 5 drops. Okay then. Did I learn something new? I saw the same kind of cards. I mean, there was actually no new cards at all in this game. So, don't really know. Is there a reason to not play these self-assemblers on the draw? And they also have the 4 mana removal that taps my land. But what else would I be having in here then? I don't want to play the poisoners, at least both of them, because they have this 1 damage effects there. I kind of feel like that I just want to have my own removal that I can use to deal with their flyers, and then I can win the late game with this self assemblers and other expensive cards. Maybe the Bazaar Barge isn't that great, but then again, it does draw me a card anyway. Because I definitely want to go to 5 mana always in every game. So I want to draw the card. Okay, let's try it. I'm not sure if this is a good matchup for me, but at least I won one game. Okay, good hand. First striker. Okay, it can deal some damage to me. And they had that, of course, so I don't get even the artifact from there, because it would have been quite nice to get it and then play this brawler. 6-6 crew 3. That can be problematic, I think. And I cannot double spell in here, because if I play one of these monitors, I will have only one mana available. And this won't be... I won't be able to improvise this guy, so I'll just play this. Sweatworks Brawler. And, problem is... if they play something and crew this, okay, they will have to tap this and whatever they play, I will take 6. Or I could double block, which could be very risky then. I think I have to actually just attack with this and take the 6. That has haste. Okay, this is bad. Why they do that, though? Well, I mean... this is better now that they actually sacrificed their guy, but... okay, and I do have a blocker for this thing too, so it doesn't seem that bad now. But they will be crewing this thing. That's sure. That's a sure thing. But it is 6-6, I can block it with a... 3-3. Now I could... raise here, but... they have those boost spells. Although the boost spells are very tough when I'm going to block. Maybe I will triple block. It's 9-9. It will be able to kill all of my guys, but... maybe I just have to triple block this thing. Because I do have this self-assemblers coming up now. I have card draw. Raising is way too risky. So I will actually... because there's also an option to attack with the Weldfast Monitor. So... but in that case, if they have the +3/+3 thing, then I'm gonna double block this with... yeah, it's gonna be too harsh. I can't do that. I will just try to stabilize by not dealing damage at all. Yep, that's fine. Also a reason to leave all of these guys to block. Hope they don't have any trick. It has only trample and haste. They do. Okay, that's bad. That is... well, I mean, wait a minute. They had a trick that also made it die. What does it do? +2/+2. Doesn't get indestructible. Yeah, I had 6 power. Okay, well that... I thought that when they played the trick that they actually are not interested in. I mean, it was a 2/2 and all that. Now, of course, if they play something which has 3 power, I still am gonna take a lot of damage. Yeah, I need the self-assembler in here. Well, they did play something which has 3 power. If I draw a land now, I can kill that. And play the self-assembler. Well, I suppose I can play the Weldfast Monitor anyway, but problem is, of course, that... well, I did draw the land. Yeah, if I would have played this, there are only 6 total toughness. They would have both died. With double self-assembler, I can double block with these self-assemblers and... and one of them will survive, unless they have also the +3/+3. I mean, problem here is that they have drawn four lands and apparently 9 spells. It is problematic because they can easily have the kind of a... what's this? Boost spell. And of course they need to play a creature first, but I can't attack. It's way too risky because if I attack and they play 3 power, then I have to jump block. I can't do that, so I can't really pressure them currently. Okay, what's this? Vehicles get more... tapped. Okay, that's... I need removal for this thing right away. I have to play the card drop spell, even if it drops to me to 3 life. Okay, I do. I mean, if they have a maybe they do that just to. Yeah, they just did they? They can't keep that. No, it would have to be a. What? Why would they do that? It's not indestructible. So if you do reveal dwarf and vehicle cards. Okay, it wasn't. It wasn't instant. It went. It went to the bottom of the library, right? Well, it doesn't show here. Okay, but now I can double block this thing safely. So that's good. And now I need to draw removal for this thing before it he finds anything else. I did not. It's too risky. But I need to start dealing some damage too. That is, I need to just deal damage. I guess I have to just, because I didn't draw anything too good here, so I just have to take some risks now. I mean, of course, they couldn't have removal of the Chandra Spiral Helix that I didn't actually think about. Well, it's too late now. It is too late now. I mean, I take the additional blocker. I thought that one removal is not enough, but it is if they have the Pyro Helix, so. Well, that's fine, but I need to draw removal for the flyer. By the way, they could have also used the. I forgot that they had them. puzzle knot in there. Yeah, well, none of this matters anymore. But yeah, they actually could have just puzzle knotted my 3-1 and made me jump block. Okay. I didn't draw my removals, so. I drew one of them. It's not enough here. Kind of disappointing here, but that's how it goes. Sometimes. But well, I guess I deserved it because I didn't. I mean, I forgot the puzzle knot was on the battlefield, so the turn when I played it, the fabricate guy as I used it for a token, that was a mistake. I should have played as a 4-2, of course. Okay, and so here we have two drops and 3-drop. Well, I'm keeping this. I just don't want to draw double self-assemblers in my opening hand, but what can I do? So this is gonna be a 1-4 then. If they so decide. Okay, well, I have a Death Toucher against that. So, do I want to make 1-1s? I don't think I want to make 1-1s in here. Because they have a good blocker for them. So, I'll just play the Harvester in here. Okay, let's see their trick. No trick. Okay. This costs 4 to activate. Okay, this is a decent one because I will have a no counter spell gladly. I will have a bunch of energy now. Not gonna use it for lifelinking purposes. This thing actually now... This thing can deal 6 damage to a player or planeswalker. Okay. So they are at 11. Or I can have a lot of pings. So if they have an artificer... Okay. And there's all the self-assemblers, of course. Let's take the... I mean, I can just use this to kill this. Would I rather do that? Actually, I'm not going to do it right now. I can attack for one. Of course, they can equip... They can equip this thing. It will cost 2 mana. It's going to be a 2-3. Or if I can attack them to... They can also actually play this conviction. Which means that I can still deal the 6 damage once because I have 2 more energy in here. I think I will rather do this now that they are tapped out. Okay, so now I maybe just use the Die Young. Now I get rid of the Conviction. They didn't want to equip it because then the Harvester would have still been lethal. I mean, I can just attack with the Harvester anyway. They can't block it because I can ping it. But I'd rather actually just do it like this. So I can pay any amount of energy and they, so I will pay 4 energy. For -4/-4, and then I can play this thing, and I can equip, not equip, but crew this thing with this, that guy, this guy that cannot attack. So I don't have 8 energy for this thing, but I have a lot of pings here at least, if nothing else, and I can make one once now with this thing. So does this mean that I'm just... Well, no, not because this costs mana to give menace. But if I attack with all, that's 6 damage actually. Assuming they don't have a trick with that thing. Yeah, I think I know what I'm gonna do. So just play this and decline the search because I already have all of them in my hand. And I will... crew this thing like so, and now I don't have the red mana to give menace to this monitor, but I will just trade it, and I will attack with these guys, and this has first strike, so it can't block it because I can ping it once before the after first strike damage, and I will actually make myself a token. So is that enough to artifacts to play my artifact hate here? Because I have 2 of these gremlins. Maybe I might be interested in taking out, if nothing else, these goggles. And I think this can be annoying too if the game goes very long. So I could consider sideboarding this gremlin in. How about the other stuff? Okay, I don't necessarily care about the Chandra's pyrohelix here. Yeah, I could have this one too, but let's try this and see if mind changes for potential game 3. Finally, I see one of these unlicensed disintegrations. The hand isn't optimal, but not going to mulligan this one. I do have three mana spells, and now again drawing these self-assemblers here. Okay, so Chandra Spyro Helix is definitely coming in. Both of them. Okay, so they get now more energy. Well, I can ping it with this guy at least. Or not. They have conviction and they can return the conviction when I try to disintegrate it. So maybe I should wait for them to tap out all of their white mana, because I can play the Harvester and block the Plunderer that way. That's what I will be doing. Okay, so by the way, that's actually I can kill this because I can ping. Okay, yeah, they made a mistake. I didn't realize I have this option if they attack. I really didn't believe they would attack, especially if they tap out pre-combat, because now this is just completely safe. Safe thing to do. I don't care about gaining life, no, I don't think. So I think they played a land, but just in case I messed up, I will be in combat still before they get an option to return the conviction to their hand. I will do this. And now I can unlicensed disintegrate this Bastion Mastodon. Or I can just play. Well, they weren't interested in that. I mean, I could have just played the console flagship instead, kill this theorist, and attack with the harvester, take here, because this was able to kill the Mastodon anyway. I just didn't realize it earlier, so. Maybe the gameplay isn't very good here, but at least you see now, unlike the Zendikar Rising Drafts, which were very, I was very experienced them by the time I started recording the videos. At least here I'm like not a total noob, because I have played this limited format earlier when it was the active format, but I'm really not. No, I'm pretty rusty here now, and you can see I'm probably making quite a few mistakes, and I, yeah, don't, this is not optimal play by any means. Okay, how about self-assemblers in my hand? I think I'm gonna mulligan this hand now. I know I have 2-3 drops, I'm on the play, but I'm gonna mulligan this. Yeah, this is much better, and I will get rid of, interesting. I might even be risky and take a risk and lose the self-assembler, because I have still 2 outs in the deck, so I want to keep the 3 lands in my early game here. Right. Another turtle. So blue-green energy. Perhaps. Yeah, I will scry, thank you. Well, I will keep this card surely. So I think I'll just play the Death Toucher, because I'd rather trade with the 1-4, otherwise my 2-1 first tracker is very useless, so... So let's play the Death Toucher and hope they will attack with both. Or at least with the 1-4. I'm not gonna block that, because my first tracker can get... can block that thing. So this is slow, but a way to win any long game. I think I'm going to now use the energy for the token. Yeah, they will likely trade here, I think. No, they did not. So I have options here. I don't have a 4-drop in my hand, so I don't play the card draw now. If I had, I might be interested in drawing more lands, but I don't, so... It's gonna be either the first striker that can get... can block the construct, or it's the on-curve play of this Renegade. But the Renegade doesn't do much in this board position, so I'll play the first striker instead. Ah yeah, of course they can make it a 2-5, but it doesn't really matter to me, I can just kill it. I'm not gonna be worried about the 2-5 currently. Defender and Reach, okay then. Interesting. Yeah, okay, they're not gonna block the 2-1 with this, and they're not gonna block the Death Toucher with this, so it's actually pointless to attack with the Chaser, now that you think of it. So let's attack with the Death Toucher and let's make a token. I think they are better now. That's fine. And I can play the Harvester now. It can block the 2-5. It can attack flying damage. Okay. Yeah, I mean, if they would have attacked and made this a 3-6, I would have just tapped this token and I had 2-6 damage in here. I would have lost the Chaser and one of these tokens definitely would have been worth it. Okay, finally, land. So what is going to be my... I kind of like to play the Live Fast in here. Seems like something I might want to do here. Yeah, I need to draw the card at some point, so this might be the kind of turn. I don't need to try to raise them. Of course, this is going to kill me sooner or later, but I really needed to get this from my hand and start playing some spells. I won't be able to double spell next turn unless I draw something cheap, but it's fine. And I'm not gonna attack. Okay, so I will have the 6-6 soon enough. Now that I have the unlicensed disintegration, I will most likely be playing that. That thing has reach. Nice. Why did I check it? Why did I check it? Now, not great, just great. Well, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter actually. Yeah. I just tap this for no reason. There's no point to attacking here. That becomes... I can't block it, but then again, I do have two removals for it. And they don't have any cards in hand. So it's basically now a matter of me going to double disintegration or... or the Gear Hulk. I think I want to kill this anyway, so... so let's now try this, that I have the pinger in there. Okay. I don't feel like gaining 3 life, it seems... unnecessary. So now before they draw any counterspell or anything, I'll just kill this guy. But I will leave the other one as an instant speed trick, because they can attack now and I will double block the Reservoir Walker. Okay. They actually have the 6 energy already here. So you can do this as an instant speed effect. This can be bad. Maybe I have to actually leave the disintegration here. Yeah. Okay, well, are they going to now use energy? I didn't think so. Okay. So, yeah, I mean, they are gonna have a free cast from the Marvel, so... so let's hope it's nothing too crazy. I don't think I'm going to attack with the 1-2. Okay, 4-3 flyer. So now I will actually give it lifelink, because I'm going to play the Gear Hulk. And I will take some damage from the flyer. They are most likely going to take some damage. Hopefully it's a good amount of damage to them. And it was. 8, 11 damage. Okay. So I don't have the energy to use this, but I have the unlicensed disintegration, which will be dealing 3. Okay, and they played the last card from their hand. Okay. It was a land, so maybe they just understood that there's no way they can win. So I'm definitely taking a Ruinous Gremlin. How about... do I want to have more than one? What I do not want to have. I think it's gonna be the Pyro Helix that I'm not needing currently. This chaser, but I do have to have, I do want to have some three drops, I mean two drops. So I guess it's fine like this. Yes. Okay, it's a fine hand. Two drop, three drop. I mean, of course, this doesn't necessarily get played on turn two if they don't have any decent target for it, but still. Did they keep a one lander? I suppose they did. Okay, so this might be an unexciting game. They didn't mulligan to 5, did they mulligan even to 6? I actually did not pay attention, but well, at least they now drew their second land, but I of course have here a bit of a head start now. This is requiring screwing, so it's not even that great of a 2-drop. They don't have any other 2-drop, unless it's some kind of a flash thing. Well, I'll see you soon, I guess. Okay. I think they should have mulliganed whatever hand they had there. Yeah. Well, I'm flooding out a bit, so I mean, I could have lost the game here otherwise. That's not gonna cut it. So I actually can kill them right now. Pay any amount of... Yeah. So, the point here is that I can use this thing and pay zero, right? No, I actually have 8 already, so... Yes. Yeah, of course, because the harvester gave me. Okay, well, not an interesting match 3, at least the second game of it. This was my first Kaladesh Remastered traditional draft. I will play quite a few of these now in a short time frame because it's gonna be available only for a week, and then there is only going to be the premier draft available. So that was 2-1, nice result, and I will not crack open any of my packs. So I got one pack from the promo code Try Kaladesh, I think, gives you one pack. So I'm going to open these packs only after I've finished drafting to maximize the fifth copy protection system. Because I also try to collect as much of this set as possible. So that was the first draft of this format, and I will certainly play more of this. See you next time. Bye bye.